Subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
It was a reprieve for Sachin Pilot in Rajasthan today as the High Court declared status quo on the issue of disqualification of Pilot and the Rebel Congress MLAs, that's 19 in number. For Ashok Gehlot, this means that he will have to prove his majority on the floor of the House and he only enjoys a wafer-thin majority. As the drama unfolds in Rajasthan, we are joined now by Team Pilot's counsel, senior advocate, veteran lawyer Mukul Rohtagi. Mr. Rohtagi, it's obviously a legal victory and a political victory of sorts for Sachin Pilot and for all of you representing him. So congratulations. But questions are being raised as to why Mr. Pilot is claiming dissent instead of defection. Can you explain on what basis you call this dissent and not defection? Isn't Pilot switching sides?
No, Madam Barkha. It's like this. The law says that if an MLA does an act which amounts to clearly severing all ties with his party and going over to another party or joining somebody else, crossing the floor as it were, then he will be guilty of voluntarily giving up membership of his party. Now, these are the words of the Constitution. Now, simple examples in the past have been where, let us say, a Congress member of a house goes and attends a public rally of the opposition party and sits on the same dais. Or a member of a ruling party goes to the governor with opposition members in tow and gives a memorandum, please dismiss my government and call the opposition leader to be the chief minister. These are acts which are destructive of the fact that you belong to a particular party. Now, as opposed to this, if a member of an, if an MLA says, and I gave an example, which I will repeat now on your channel. Suppose a chief minister directs a water pipeline through an MLA's district to be diverted to some other district and that A district is starving of scarcity of water and the MLA tells the chief minister you haven't done a correct thing and there is a dispute. An MLA is entitled to say, well, the chief minister is not acting in the best interest of my constituency and not in the best interest of the party to which we belong, because ultimately the electorate will throw out these people. So he's entitled to say, look here, I want a change in the leadership of my party. I want to remain a congressman. I want to remain a Gandhian, you know, in the old days. I want to remain that, but I want a change. So internal dissent, in other words, freedom of expression. I agree, I disagree with you. Even a normal individual human being has a right to disagree in our democracy. How can the right to disagree, stroke dissent, asking for, say, even removal of your own chief minister, it can never be equal to leaving the party.
But Mr. Rohtagi, you're too senior for me to remind you of this. You will remember Sharad Yadav's example when Venkaiah Naidu was Rajya Sabha chairman, disqualified Sharad Yadav because he argued that changing parties or not following the party's line amounted to anti-party activity. So in this case, that is what is being said about Sachin Pilot. How do you look at Sharad Yadav's disqualification from the Rajya Sabha?
Yeah, Barkha, two answers to your question.
Yeah.
As far as I remember, Mr. Sharad Yadav attended a rally of the opposition party.
Yeah.
Please check.
He did.
Yeah. So if you attend the rally of a opposition party, you are not going there as a bystander.
Yeah.
You are going there to express your support. And if that is so, then obviously you have made your intention publicly clear that I am going to sit on a dais of the opposition party, number one. So therefore, his facts were entirely different. And number two, if Mr. Yadav was aggrieved of his disqualification or attempts to remove him, well, he should have had better legal advice. Maybe he should have come to me.
He should have yes, he should have come to Mr. Rotaghi, best lawyer in town. No disputing that. But there's still tough questions for you. What happens when a whip is issued? Eventually, this will go to the floor of the house and there will be a whip. There will be a whip. If Sachin Pilot and his MLAs defy the whip, is that not basis to call that defection?
Yes, so you are right, Barkha. But the whips, in our case, as of now, the letter of the whip saying that you attend a party meeting in a hotel.
Yeah.
His whip does not extend to calling a meeting in a hotel. His whip is in the house. And
yeah.
If in the house, Mr. Pilot is to vote against against Mr. Gehlot or Gehlot's party or Congress party, then surely Mr. Pilot can be disqualified. No doubt about it.
Exactly. But, so what is the purpose of this whole exercise?
That's a far cry. I don't know how and when Mr. Pilot will vote and which way will he vote. I have no idea about that. All I can say is, you are right. That is a classic case of disqualification. While today this is a far cry.
Yeah.
Today this is a far cry. Where we stand today, we haven't reached. We will cross that bridge when we are required to do that.
But then aren't you just using the courts to buy political time? The argument could be made that if you accept that a whip and against the whip will disqualify him, then you're just buying time. You're using the courts to buy time.
No, Barkha, I think it's an unfair allegation. When this case started or when the dissent started a couple of months ago. It has been, boiling. It has been seething. All that has been going on for the last few months. Our case started 1 week ago. 1 week, 10 days ago, there was no call. There was no talk of any assembly session. This talk of assembly session has come into their minds because they've got a jolt from the High Court. I mean, why are they scared? High Court has taken a view. Supreme Court is sitting there. Both of us will be there in Supreme Court, one way or the other. Now, they want to preempt this case of disqualification on this ground by going somewhere else. Well, if they go somewhere else, time will tell what will happen when a house is called, session is called. We'll see what happens.
What about the Congress and Gehlot's claim of audio tapes that purportedly show bribery?
No, Barkha, I have no idea. I have no idea.
You are saying that's not admissible.
Outside the court.
You are saying that's not admissible
none
in court.
No, this is in the court proceedings.
Okay.
Not only not admissible, they are nowhere in the court proceedings currently.
According to you, does a trust vote have to wait for the Supreme Court to hear this matter and decide on it on Monday? Because Gehlot's people are sitting on dharna at the governor's house demanding an immediate trust vote.
I think the dharna is more out of anger against the High Court's verdict, I perceive. And that is why they're taking a political posture. I mean, where's the question of a dharna? Suppose you want to convene the assembly. You can go and give a memorandum to the governor. The governor has not sat on the memorandum for 20 days. The governor is also entitled to say, well, look, I'll examine your request. He'll also look at what is happening in COVID-related world. We are not going to the Supreme Court. We are not going to the High Court. We are doing cases on Zoom.
Yeah.
Now, can't the governor say that it is not safe today to call 250 people inside one closed chamber for 2 days? And suppose he defers it by 2 weeks or 20 days, what's the big deal?
Doesn't it give time for horse trading? You remember the Supreme Court in Karnataka, which was a case you're familiar with?
Look, Barkha, in all other cases, it is the opposition which demands a trust vote.
Yeah.
As in Madhya Pradesh, because the majority was wafer thin.
Yeah.
They were demanding. So if they are demanding and the governor is not doing, is a different thing. Here the man is unsure of himself. On one hand he says, I've got 25 more people. Yeah. Well, if you have 25 more people, you should relax. No. What's the great thing of calling your own trust board? I mean, okay. It's completely a different situation.
Okay, two related.
I'm not saying no.
Yeah.
I'm not saying he can never call. He can suddenly call. And the governor will ultimately assent to a flow test. But it can't be that he's at the beck and call of a chief minister that I go today at 1 o'clock and say, now call it tomorrow morning. I'm sorry, the governor is not at his beck and call.
Okay, two quick legal questions. The speaker is arguing that this is interfering with the speaker's jurisdiction and the court should have stepped in only after the speaker ruled on whether this disqualification should have happened or not.
Well, that, Barkha, that was argued by Dr. Singhvi ad nauseam.
Yeah.
Now, we argued to the contrary for a simple reason. Yes, normally it is for the speaker to decide. He is supposed to be a neutral adjudicator.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
And he is supposed to issue a notice of disqualification if there are basic facts which support that tentative conclusion. In this case, there is not a single fact which can support his issuing us a notice.
So and you're saying
the way he has acted. I have said in court that the action is mala fide. He is acting like a mouthpiece of the Congress party, and therefore the tribunal's action is liable to be stopped.
The court
has framed 15 questions or 13 questions.
Your claim remains, your essence of your argument is that your client, Sachin Pilot, remains a member of the Congress party, as do the 18 MLAs with him. That there is no switching of sides.
That, Barkha, is the bottom line. Can an MLA not raise his head in dissent or his voice in dissent? Or raising a voice of dissent will bring down a Damocles sword and cut your throat. That's the bottom line of this case.
Final question. There are 6 BSP MLAs, erstwhile BSP MLAs, who merged with the Congress. That has also become part of the legal mess of this case. Where do you weigh in on that?
You see, many months ago, an MLA called Madan Dilawar filed a petition before the Speaker in the month of March, saying that they should be disqualified because 6 of them have joined, and that is not 2/3 of the BSP. The law is clear. Mm. 2/3 of a political party, if it joins another party, it is deemed to be a valid merger.
Yeah.
6 people of BSP National Party is not 2/3. They are liable to be disqualified straight away. It is like 1+1=2. No fact is required to be proved. In that case, Mr. Speaker, who is now very agitated, Mr. Speaker, for 5 months has not issued even a notice.
Yes.
Has not issued a notice as compared to our position. That petition is received by him in the day. Within 2 hours, he issues the notice and he tells us to reply by 1 o'clock in 3 days. Otherwise, the consequences will follow. Is that treatment of a neutral, by a neutral tribunal?
Finally, what will be the essence of your argument before the Supreme Court on Monday? You've got a status quo reprieve from the High Court, but this matter still has to be determined by the Supreme Court.
Yes, so Madam Barkha, no problem. We will place the order of the High Court before the Supreme Court. Supreme Court is the last court. They will decide whether they want to decide the whole case. They may call the case from the High Court also. They may ask the High Court to decide. They may defer their proceedings because it's not possible to have parallel proceedings going on.
And you're saying a trust vote? Are you saying a trust vote cannot take place till the Supreme Court adjudicates on this larger matter of the role of the Speaker? Are you arguing that the trust vote cannot
according
take place
to
at such time?
According to me, in all fairness, the trust vote must wait because the Supreme Court is deciding it with utmost expediency. And if the Supreme Court decides in a week or 10 days, jolly well the trust vote can wait. Why preempt issues? Why complicate political issues?
Okay, Team Pilot, Senior Counsel Mukul Rohtagi, pleasure talking to you. Bye and thank you.